With the Petronas Towers and Kuala Lumpur skyline in the picture, a very warm welcome to the 2022 Petronas Malaysian Open. After a week's break, the HSBC BWF World Tour has relocated from Indonesia to the magnificent Ashanta Arena in the southern suburbs of Kuala Lumpur. It's day two of competition here in this Super 750 tournament, which is the 11th event on the 2022 World Tour calendar. And this is a Super 750 tournament. That means we have eight matches lined up for you today. And here is the order of play. Lots of interesting matches coming up. First of all, women's singles, where we have the former world champion Pusarla Venkata Sindhu from India taking on the SEA Games silver medalist Phittayaporn Chaiwan. Then mixed doubles, and there's going to be home interest. Go Sung-hwat and Shivan Jamie Lai is up against the new Korean combination. Women's singles, following that match, An Se-yong, the third seed, and well, number three, up against Han Yue. And then women's doubles, where the young Malaysian pair, Tan and Tina, are doing so well. They're up against the unseeded combination, another unseeded combination, Zhang and Zheng from China. And men's doubles, the Olympic champions, Li and Wang, they're up against the independent pair from Malaysia, Ong and Tiu. And in the following matches, more Olympic champions in terms of Victor Axelsen, his big rival in the men's singles, Li Sijaro, is up against Rustavito. And we finish it all off with the England champions from Indonesia, Fikri Maulana, up against the world champions Hoki and Kobayashi from Japan. So here is the women's singles draw. We are in the lower part of the draw here, and we can see that Pusarla Venkata Sindhu is the seventh seed, and she actually defeated the SEA Games gold medalist in the first round, Pompawi Chuchuwong. And a mouth-watering clash could be in waiting in the quarterfinal there if the seeds make it through. Here is the two players. It's Chaiwan leading Pusarla Venkata Sindhu. Sindhu won the World Championship back in 2019 in Basel. Well, it's good to be back here in the Ashanta Arena after 2 years of hiatus following the COVID-19 pandemic. So, first job for the umpire is the coin toss.
Red or black? Red, so black is for you. It's black. She wants to receive. That side. Okay, good luck.
So, Phittayaporn Chaiwan on the coin toss and elected to receive. And PV Sindhu got to choose ends, and she chose to start in the far end of the court. More on that later on the different sides of the courts. But, here we have Phittayaporn Chaiwan, formerly known as Patarasura Chaiwan, but she changed her name following a visit to a temple. She's 21 years of age from Lampang in the northern part of Thailand, close to Chiang Mai. Currently ranked 20th on the world ranking, which is one shy of her highest, which she held for 3 weeks as number 19 on the World Tour ranking. The one that only counts the World Tour events, no championships or SEA Games or anything. She is 33rd. She defeated Fitriani from Indonesia in the first round in straight games. And that was actually the first time she played in this Ashanta Arena, which might be why she did not choose ends here, winning the coin toss. Pusarla Venkata Sindhu turns 27 on Tuesday, which incidentally also is the World Badminton Day. She's ranked 7th and also seeded 7th in this tournament. It has been in top 2. She's also second ranked in the World Tour, where she's already won 2 tournaments on this year's World Tour calendar. There, as you can see, the results from the first round, where she defeated Pompavi Chuchuwon, who recently fell ill and might not be at the best of shape at the moment.
Ready to play.
Here's our umpire, Jörg Huberts from Germany. And Idiri Singhi from Sri Lanka is keeping an eye on the service height. Shuttle must be struck. All of the shuttle must be below 115 centimeters when struck, and that's the service judge who takes care of that. So, Chaiwan, one of the young upcoming talents from Thailand, not had the best year here. Best result, clearly the silver medal at the Southeast Asian Games, where she lost the All-Thailand final to Chuchuwon. Otherwise, second round in Indonesia, Subathausen, where she lost to Okohara, is her best result this year.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Pusarla Sindhu, India. And on my left, Phittayaporn Chaiwan, Thailand. Pusarla Sindhu to serve. Lavo. Play.
Sindhu, clearly the more experienced of the two players here, with 5 World Championship medals and 2 Olympic medals. But hasn't really done that well in Malaysia Open. The best result is the semi-final in 2018. Malaysian Masters a couple of times. And, that was not in this arena. Once it was played in Penang, and once it was played in Kuala Lumpur, but in a different arena. Then this is Yanta arena here. To start. Good pressure there from Chaiwan. From Sindhu. He chose ends and elected to stomp on the far side of the court, where she's playing up against the drift. Drifting alongside the court, coming from China towards Sindhu. Judging from the first round play, it's been rather severe. The drift. See, it's difficult for Sindhu to get the correct length on her shots.
5-3. Thank you.
big smash from the former world champion.
4-5.
An attacking playing style that's favored here in the Shouts Arena. Good control by Chaiwan. That first service return, that was well done. Put Sindhu under a lot of pressure. Swinging by the coach's corner there, where Park Tae-sung is sitting. Sindhu's coach, the former Korean international. Oi, oi, oi. A total mishit. But I heard that the same thing happened for Victor Axelsen when he was playing yesterday, also in a bit of trouble in his first game against the Priest Levadez. Eventually went on to win.
8-6
on this center court here. There was the right leg from Sindhu.
Serve is over. 6-8.
Deception. Excellent deception. That is definitely one of the things that she should be using a lot from this near side of the court. Chaiwan, yeah, she should also be using it from the opposite, that is, because one of the keys here is to get your opponent out of balance. So when you're out of balance, it's not so easy to adjust to the drift. Again, the cross from the backhand, round the head corner there. Efficient shot from Sindhu here in the early stages of the match. Sindhu. You can see that Chaiwan was on her way back there, had to come full court.
Service over.
Another good deception on the service return, and it's Chaiwan who's in the lead here at the first mid-game interval. 3 points up, 11-8.
About 1:20 seconds.
little bit surprised that Sindhu chose the final to start.
11-9. Play.
I see it as the best end for singles play. The chance we've had in the first round here, where she can really push her shots.
Service over.
But
then
get off to a good start and then sort of follow up on it in the second game, attacking a lot more than in the first. That might have been the plan, but so far Chaiwan has played really well on the front court.
Service over. 12-10.
Objectives, in my opinion, would be for Sindhu to overcome the front court here in the first game and force Chaiwan to play the Indian back court with accuracy.
It's
a risky shot. Tries there,
well.
Chaiwan playing sharp into the net from. A bit far. She's around the service line there when she tries to play that sharp. Good deception again. Gives her the upper hand in the rally. Back to on square. To leave a couple of shots 30. When you play the far side there, you've got to make sure that you're not playing too big a court. It might cost. It's better to have a look early in the game. It doesn't feel as if there's as much at stake as if it's really close towards the end. Good attack.
Over. 13-0.
This is simply a little bit too late on the front court, Sindhu there. Drift, but again, there was a smash from Sindhu that wasn't hit completely clear. So the timing is difficult at these early stages of the tournament. Benefits players with short racket movement in the attacking situation. To get the right timing.
Service over.
If you have a short swing.
14-0.
Placement again.
15-40.
Just inside the line. Long smash. Now we miss it.
16-40.
good pressure from Chaiwan on that flat lift there.
Service over. 15-16.
Yes, he's had some problems with the from Sindhu has Chaiwan. Good attack.
16-0.
Deception there by Chaiwan. That's a chance. Missed it.
17-16.
So he was trading for most part of that rally there, so a little bit of a lucky point. There was going to be a lot of to cover there for Sindhu had that gone over.
Okay.
Now in the lead for the first time since 2-1. Distance. Missed it, Sindhu.
Service over. 17-18. Line drop.
Seems to get in trouble on directly from the service when she's using her backhand short serve. There are lots of good disguises from Chaiwan, and I'm a little bit surprised that we haven't seen Sindhu use the flick serve here. It's an ideal opportunity to really punch the flick serve up against the drift. Put your opponent under pressure from the beginning. Instead, it seems like Sindhu is getting under pressure from the early stages of the rallies. Chaiwan has had to be so much more careful because she's playing with the drift. That's excellent play.
Edgy-oh. Over 19-18.
That's the way to do it. Got to attack when you have the chance, even on the far side of the court, because otherwise your opponent will do it. It's a great play by Chaiwan, but not impressed with the tactical approach from Sindhu in that service situation. Game point opportunity for Phittayaporn Chaiwan, who in my opinion has done really well in this first game here. Good technical skills on the front court, taking the chance when it occurred. Can she take the first game? She can. That's found the line, and the first game to Phittayaporn Chaiwan, 21-19. That is a little bit surprising to me, but nonetheless well deserved. She really created her own luck, did Chaiwan. Interesting to see what happens now when the play is changed. Ends before the second game. Here's confirmation of the score in the first. 21-19.
I think the movement is better to the feet. And Lobo start first game first. Come on. Okay. And but at the service push. Oh, left and all straight block. Pull the block and close. And lift the straight smash. Close smash is okay, you can take no problem. But straight lift and straight smash is how many mistakes? Right? At the lift, here. And at the block.
Court 1, 20 seconds.
Some instructions from Pusarla to PV Sindhu. I think Sindhu must feel that the near side here is the better of the two. That's the only explanation I can find for the choice of ends, having seen the first game there. So, second game underway.
Serve is over. One love.
I think Sindhu should definitely try to be attacking, because it's difficult to play the back line, but she's still having trouble with that short deception on the service return.
1-0.
For Chaiwan, the key is that she can use the back line and she can really push it. So she should do that as variation. It'd probably have gone long had she left it. Oh, that's well controlled by Sindhu, that lift there.
2-1. one.
And one of the keys for Chaiwan is to use the backcourt of PV Sindhu. Still, she can use deceptions, but she also needs to chase her around with flat lifts. Pressure clears, but that clear here was way, way too short.
One.
Look at where Sindhu's feet is. Almost mid-court area. An easy kill. Sindhu looks much more comfortable on this near side of the court.
Six, one.
Well, often playing in these windy conditions, it's just as much playing the drift as playing the opponent. Chaiwan is playing too much front court. That's well done by Sindhu. Good defense.
Seven,
flat game
one.
Actually wasn't really defense, but she stood her ground in the flat game. First time she's at the correct length, Chaiwan. Let's hit again, but that is simply due to the drift.
Seven. Nine,
thank you. A very good start for former world champion here to the second game.
Two, seven.
It's gone.
Three, seven.
Utilize the backcourt of Sindhu going into a flat game battle. Sindhu has the advantage of reach. 15 centimeters taller than her opponent. It's gone wide, and in double quick time, PV Sindhu is 8 points up here in this second game, 11-3 at the mid-game interval.
Attempting this from this court, right? So you have to choose it. You
not easy mistake. Don't easy mistake. And remember,
got one. 20 seconds.
Smash. Black. Close.
Got one.
Move. Remember.
20 seconds.
Situation where we probably won't see Chaiwan make too much of an effort to get back in this second game. She's simply fallen too far behind. But one of the important things is that you figure out a way to play the far side of the court ahead of an eventual third game. And the problem is, if she puts deceptions on the shots from below the tape there, she will lose power and she won't be able to hit it hard enough to get the good length on her shots. And then she plays it totally into the hand of PV Sindhu.
Set is over. 4:30.
The way to do it, but she's not really laid the foundation for challenging Sindhu on the backcourt, making the court big.
5:30.
We'll see the men's singles. We'll definitely see players selecting the far side as the better side. Because, they have the tools physically to make it tough on the opponent on the near side here. Good play by Chaiwan. And then she misses that one. There's a challenge. It is called good by the lines judge on the back line. The best position here is if he's sitting over one of the adjacent courts, but it looked like it had gone long. Yeah.
Correction.
Challenge by PV Sindhu.
15-6 play.
Sindhu is only playing on the first 50% of the court because Chaiwan is not making attempts at playing the back court. Deception on the front court there.
Seven,
from PV Sindhu.
Eight.
That's the way to do it. Well played by Chaiwan. One of the keys is, as I mentioned, not to use deceptions and try and play the backcourt. If you want to play the backcourt, play it directly without deception. So when you put a little deception on, it's almost always going to be a shot to the front court. Whereas from Sindhu's side, you can play deceptions in both the long and the short ones. And also just kill it like she did there.
Service over. 19-8.
It's gone wide, and now 12. Game point opportunities for the former world champion to send this first match of the day into decider. I think, no, stayed in. That looked like there was a bit of sideways drift right to left. Haven't really been able to pick up much on the sideways drift. It's a lot easier to see when you're sitting directly behind the court. That looked to me like there was some kind of drift. Anyway, second game.
Second game won by Pusarla Sindhu, 21.
Convincingly to PV Sindhu, and we headed to a decider, as this was the winning rally of the second game. PV Sindhu took it in double quick time, 21-9.
Okay, enough, Sindhu. So if Sindhu consider the first game very well, okay? But it leaves the point of the French stands man. And black, that is close. Don't forget the level. It's very important, Sindhu, okay? And after service, she is losing him, Sindhu. Sometimes push, push, push. Only people 11 single. Little hard, change court, convenience. Convenience is okay. Relax. Usually it's okay. We no get points in 4-7, it's okay. It changes. But you have to link at you, single. Okay.
Court 1, 20 seconds.
So, ready for the third and final game here. Phittayaporn Chaiwan took the first game 21-19. PV Sindhu was clinical in the second.
Final
21-9.
Game.
21-9. Level. And judging from the way the two players have performed, we have to say that PV Sindhu, the seventh seed in this tournament here, is the favorite going into the decider. It's gone wide. It's going wide in the other side. Really worked well for PV Sindhu. sacrificing herself, Chaiwan, but in vain.
Thank you.
A really good start for the seventh seed. Continuing Sindhu where she left in the second game. Totally confused and disheartened, Phittayaporn Chaiwan. It must be a little bit difficult for Sindhu to concentrate. There's a huge crowd behind her court wanting to have photos and autographs from one of the players finishing on the adjacent courts here. We've got four courts laid out in the Ashanta Arena here for the early stages of the tournament. Missed it.
2-5.
And the key is to play the backcourt when you're in balance. When you're out of balance, then it's very difficult to get the right length on the shots. And then you want to have an open front court so that you can sort of get yourself out of trouble playing the front court. But really put pressure on the backcourt when you're in balance. Excellent play, excellent play. That's the way to play from the far side of the court. And now Chaiwan is being made to work on full court instead of just the front 60% of the court, more or less. She left it, Sindhu. I don't mind.
3-7.
Neither did Chaiwan because it stayed in, but it's, as I mentioned earlier, so important to take a look, and especially when you're ahead. It doesn't feel as costly as if it's close.
4-7.
Positions where she can't control the drift, so she starts to realize that it's impossible to hit the backcourt with accuracy. It's also important. That's gone wide left.
9-4.
And Sindhu in good shape. There was the flicker. Excellent play there by Chaiwan.
5-9.
Really good disguised shots from the front court. And she's taking it high.
6-9.
Sindhu, when she plays a defensive clear like that one, it has reasonable length, but I mean, there's no doubt that Chaiwan is going to attack on the next one. I mean, what else should you do? Try to play a clear, playing with the drift, that would be a tough task.
Thank you.
Catching up a little bit here towards the mid-game interval. Important for the tie that she probably should have had. A comfortable lead if she was to go to win this match.
Service over. 10-7.
Went wide, but look at the length. A lot of length to work with. Yeah, she's good track, Chaiwan. Yeah, excellent.
9-10.
It's very difficult to play yourself out of it from Sindhu's perspective. Winning all the flat game exchanges from this near side of the court. Chaiwan gets a little bit extra pace in it and utilizing the good technical skills. So back to all square after being down 3-8. Oh, that's the best rally of the match so far. And it's PV Sindhu who is in the lead, but only by the narrowest of margin, 11-10. Now the question is, can Chaiwan be a fast learner and play that far side a lot better than she did in the second game? Last chance for the coaches to offer their advice. As we change ends here at the mid-game interval in the third game, Sindhu up 11-10.
Coaches, take your chair.
So everything is at stake here as PV Sindhu is up 11-10 in the decider against Phittayaporn Chaiwan.
12-10.
And again, the player on the far side of the court seems a little surprised that there's going to be an attack. Made to run the long distance, Chaiwan. He's too short. Good pressure. That's excellent play by PV Sindhu.
15-10.
All 4 points since the change of end to the Indian number one. So, Nadal was also in this tournament but lost the first round to Harris Wang. Ooh, that was fantastic. How did she get that back?
Service over.
11-50. Took the top of the tape, but Chaiwan managed to play a magnificent net shot there. Tape on Sindhu's side. And again, you've got to expect when you play it clear from that position. To expect there's going to be an attack, and again it's the cross attack from the backhand side that does the trick for PV Sindhu. another good rally, and again it was PV Sindhu who won it. Chaiwan playing a lot of shots from the backcourt. I don't think all of them would have stayed in. In that case, it would have taken almost superhuman control from Sindhu.
Service over.
That's a good shot. There it is again. The go-to shot in this match for PV Sindhu. And has so many points. From Chaiwan.
Phittayaporn Chaiwan challenges.
Second challenge of the match. In. It's there's a review system on the line, so successful challenge.
Challenge unsuccessful.
Sindhu.
One challenge
just 2 points off a quarterfinal berth.
14. Play.
But you also have to aware from the border and you get ready. Be ready for the import. Okay? And the line just the other. Please look at me when you get the
good shot. Wow, that's extremely well played by PV Sindhu. Good pressure, good movement. Mate, Chaiwan. Work the full court, good control, keeping that one in. And match point has arrived. 6 match points to 12-5 for the quarterfinals. 31 shots.
Taiwan.
What's the rally? Been PV Sindhu on the majority of the long rallies. And there it is, first time of asking. A good flicker and a follow up. She was close in the first game, PV Sindhu. Chaiwan. Played magnificently and stole it in the end, but the former world champion came back and dominated the second and the third game here. And the match lasting just under an hour. Here's confirmation of the score, 19-21, 21-9, 21-14. So welcome back here to the Ashanta Arena after that first win for former world champion. We turn our attention to mixed doubles.